Are there any statements from honourable members? And I call the honourable member for Fremantle.
Thank you, Deputy Speaker. I'm sure that I'm one of many people in this place who's been hearing from their constituents about the importance of community television and the disappointment at the government's decision to force community TV out of the free-to-air spectrum. As David Green, a Melbourne comedian and community TV presenter, wrote in the Sydney Morning Herald a few days ago, community television became the latest target for nation unbuilding recently when Communications Minister Malcolm Turnbull announced TV signals would be switched off at the end of 2015. Enforcing community TV out of television, it is no answer to say that the internet represents the future for such broadcasting, especially not from the coalition which, during a former stint in government, bequeathed to Australia the parlous state of broadband infrastructure that followed the privatisation of Telstra and which is now working to dismantle the NBN. As the community TV sector has been saying loudly and clearly, the shift to the internet is already underway, and it's a shift that will take time for community and commercial operators alike. So on what basis should the community sector access to spectrum be pushed off a cliff? Like many West Australians, I enjoy West TV, and I've been fortunate enough to participate in some of its local programming, including current affairs shows like Undercurrent. The community TV sector is an important part of diversity and local character in Australia's media, and an important incubator of ideas and talent. Silencing community TV is yet another sad example of this government's nation unbuilding.